far. Never lead debate.
All right, so here's the deal. We are pre-post show about to go live here in about 5 minutes. For some reason, because it's what we do, we had a debate which Beverly brother was which. Now, you guys, if you're asking who the Beverly
Blake
brother...
Blake had the mustache.
Bo Beverly was Mike Enos, and he had a mustache. He became a jobber on Nitro. Watch. So we decided YouTube wasn't enough. We're going to Google image this shit for the sake of the show. You see, I have Blake Beverly. Michael, you want to drum roll this before we hit search? Blake Beverly has no fucking...
What's that?
That's a mustache.
Huh?
Wait a minute. They both came up.
Oh.
That decided nothing.
That's bullshit.
That solved
shit. But
the
first one was a mustache.
That doesn't mean anything.
That's the first one.
You know what? We got a show to do. We're going to resolve this right here on the Slam Pigs podcast. Feeling good this... We're back.
I won.
Yeah, I don't know. That... We'll be back. We'll address it on the show.
Sunday night, September the 25th, Slam Pigs 28 live for us.
We're back.
We are back for the two-week hiatus. I know you guys have been fired up, waiting for us to come back.
Lots of feedback about it.
We are back, so wait no longer. The show is back. Travis and I are back.
I put it on Facebook, just like Terry Funk.
Forever!
Oh, Jesus Christ.
Forever!
Michael, welcome back to the show.
Welcome back to you.
You had a little trip in York, PA on a
York,
pool
PA,
tournament.
Did a little pool.
Had a good amount of success.
Yeah, won the whole thing. It was a long weekend, but it was worth it.
And as everyone saw before the show, another successful thing, we did find out the results of the Blow Blake Beverly campaign. Get him a blowjob, people, because he's not.
Travis finally realized which Beverly was which after I had to point it out. Yeah, that was the sound of him being wrong, if you didn't catch that.
The sound of being wrong is someone hitting a table.
Yeah.
Yep. I can't believe that shit. I still can't believe it. And you know, well,
welcome.
Let's come clean. This is the second time running through this, streamlining it. This show has had such a string of bad luck. Had Corey the Bagel Guy live from the CWC post show. Called him on the spot after the show. Set that shit up for months. He was behind Sasha Banks. Everyone saw the pictures. I'll put him up right now on the video if you're watching it on YouTube, if you're not just listening to it. Bad audio. Try to do the same show again with our guest here for the post-show. Logan, welcome, by the way, man, with Logan. Audio problems again. Logan, how are you doing, man? Finally.
Well, I don't feel like it's audio problems.
Are we cursed? Are you getting us cursed because of your karma and being a dick to people?
Why am I?
Yeah, everyone heard it last week, the tail end. I couldn't take it anymore like Popeye.
Really?
It's all I can takes, and
really?
I can't takes no more.
Well, I'm sorry I can't be Mr. Nice Guy all the time like you. I say what everyone's thinking, and they can say it whether they like it or not. I say what people are thinking. You say the publicly correct thing. I say what people are actually thinking. That's the way the world works.
Well, thank you, Sanjay.
If I was running for president, I would win before you would. You think people hate me? I think more people love me.
Because all the good
me.
Candidates always leave or get kicked out early. They lose.
Well, I think I'm the person that says what people want to hear, and you're the person that says what you think people want to hear.
This has happened on the Hard to Name podcast. Let's go ahead and announce it next week on the Hard to Name podcast. First time ever guest. Who's coming to the show, Michael?
Me.
Michael on the Hard to Name podcast. Check it out next week, guys, when it drops. Adam and I are really excited to have you on. We're going to talk top three Super Nintendo sports games, Michael. I know that is your bread and butter as far as classic gaming.
Yeah, I love me some sports games, whatever console it's on. I think we played our fair share as children, and I still do to this day.
As children!
Yes.
God, you get all loud about
children.
It.
Children!
This is the second
I was going a little Devon Dudley on you. He's in the rumors this week, by the way. I didn't even put this on the format, but there is a rumor of his return coming up in WWE.
As a single.
Yeah.
As Reverend.
Testify!
Devon? As Reverend?
Yeah. Could be. As a similar character.
He's going to have Batista's manager?
I don't fucking know. I'm just going
well,
on
you're
the
dropping
rumors.
The hot news.
I talked to Tuna Meltzer. It's what he told me.
Oh, Logan!
Yeah.
Welcome back to the Slam Pigs podcast.
Welcome back, Logan.
Hold down your excitement, Michael. A Clash of Champions post show. Almost said CWC. What's going on, man? Let's do this one more time. Where can everyone check you out on Future Pro Wrestling on Facebook?
Facebook, YouTube, YouTube Pro Wrestling Entertainment is live. It's here. It's now. This is what it's all about. The post show, and I'm back, baby.
Great.
I know Michael is excited. Had a lot of feedback about you, Logan. They loved the Fired Up. Real quick, let's run through it. Why are you fired up this week?
Why am I fired up?
You sound real fired up.
I'm sick and tired of the Roman Reigns winning the big matches. Rusev should have came out of this night
Rusev?
As the championship holder. It's like when Roman Reigns wins, it's like biting into a stupid lemon.
The world frowns.
It's like the sound of fingernails scratching the chalkboard. I'm so fired up when I see Roman Reigns because he sucks. He's terrible. Terrible on the mic. Yeah, he's all right in the ring, whatever. He has his three moves of doing like John Cena. You know, it's like the feeling of getting dumped by your girlfriend. That's what it feels like when I watch Roman Reigns.
Speaking of that, when's the last time you had a girlfriend?
Michael, don't you start with me.
Will you be serious? We gotta go through this again.
What? What did I do?
Let the man finish his Roman fired up.
I'm sorry.
Go ahead, Logan.
Go ahead, Mr. Mears.
Pathetic. It's amazing how they can keep pushing somebody like he's a damn Superman when he needs his kryptonite. Just get rid of him. Put him off my TV screen. Reign supreme my ass. Okay? Roman Reigns is why it rains and it pours when it comes to the WWE. Vince, I don't understand why he has this. It's like he's, you know, he loves his little Roman Reigns. He's, you know, oh, he likes that little tattoo on his arm. He likes flexes when he flexes, you know, with his long black hair, his Samoan. I hate it. Drop. I can't stand Roman Reigns anymore, and I used to be a fan of him back in the day.
Well, there you have it. I think
he sounded about as fired up as a fucking 6-year-old when he didn't get his candy.
I can stand Roman Reigns. I think he can live up to his end in the match. I can't stand him how he's booked as like a Samoan John Cena. I like the Usos now that they're heel. I think
first of all, can we get this out of the way?
What?
Is it a rule?
What's a rule?
I think I asked you this earlier. If you're Samoan, do you have to use a Samoan drop in a match?
Yep. Just like if you're a Hart, you have to use what, Michael?
A sharpshooter.
Yep. If you have any affiliation to a Hart, yeah. If you're a friend
of
a Hart.
Tyson Kidd, Cesaro.
If you know them, you're using a sharpshooter.
Yeah.
So, yeah.
So I don't understand why everybody doesn't use it.
Speaking of questions this week, we got a fan question from Melanie off
Twitter.
Yeah,
we'll get to that.
So, thank you, Melanie, for your question. Thank you for listening.
That was fired up. It didn't sound real fired up, if you ask me. It's kind of sounded like, come on, Logan.
I'm not going to pay attention to you anymore, Michael.
That's all right. The listeners pay attention to me, and that's why they come to the show.
At this point, I just think you're drunk.
Shit. You ain't seen
you're
me
thinking
drunk.
About the wrong host then. Right
yeah.
Now.
You ain't seen me drunk, buddy. If I was drunk, I'd be really hurting your feelings.
Can we move on, guys, from this awkward silence and get the show on the road? Follow us on Twitter at SlamPigsPodcast. Follow me on Twitter at TheHibikiTMD right here on HibikiTMD.
All right.
Always hit that
Your
subscribe
voice
button.
Finally changed?
I got to hit that every time I hit that plug, just like that.
Right here!
That's my sound. That's my sound bite. Like I said, he was talking about the wrong host.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Yeah, let's get this shit on the road. Opening match. We're not even going to talk about the pre-show. Nia Jax beats Alicia Fox. What do we do? Opening match. Tag team title match, Michael. The New Day. Day number 399 as your W.
They get the win.
W. You know the rest.
Yeah.
Tag team champions. Solid match with the Bullet Club. New Day won with interference. Heel tactics from Xavier Woods on the outside with Francesca too. Michael, Logan, I know how you guys feel about it already. Logan, let me kick this off with you. Did the right team win?
No. I don't see why they won tonight. I don't see why. I don't understand it. You know, is it me? Or does it just make no sense at all anymore? I mean, I guess maybe it's what you alluded to before we started. But
I don't see why we keep having this guy on the show, to be honest with you, Travis.
Really?
I mean, so many other guests we could have on this show, and we have him every post-show. Like, really? I let you take control of a lot of reins around here, no pun intended, to Roman. But this is the guy that you picked for every post show. Can you explain yourself, Travis?
Logan is a good guy. You know what? I thought we did great when you weren't here last
week. Well, let's have a poll this week. Who thinks we should have Logan Mayers on for every post show, and who thinks we should have somebody else on there? Let us know on Hibiki TMD. Let us know at the Slam Pigs Podcast on Twitter or the Slam Pigs Podcast on Facebook. Let us know.
Okay, if we're going to do that, okay, who thinks we should just kick Michael off for one post show and I'd be Michael for the night?
He did enjoy being Michael. I remember opening up that show saying, "You're in the shoes, Michael, for the first time," and he was like, "Finally, I've made it." He was thrilled.
Well, that's how most people feel when they feel like they can be like me. I mean, I understand it.
Jesus.
I mean, it's probably his life's ambition. I'm sure he sat there thinking, "Man, I wish I could be as witty and sexy and good looking."
Oh, will you be serious? Sexy? Fucking Lex Luger over here with his mirrors. No pun intended.
Logan.
All right. Logan is a good guy. I think you're a little rude to guests sometimes. But
like I've said before, I say what everybody else is thinking.
You don't know that.
I have listeners that are in our town that tell me.
You got a guy that tells you?
I have more than one.
Joey Bag of Donuts?
I have more than one.
Jeez.
And they're like, "What is up with this Logan guy, man? Like, can we get him to unfall asleep? And fucking, because every time he comes on the show,
why are you getting in my face?
He makes
like,
me.
What is that?
I'm just saying.
God.
That's what I get from people.
You're fired up.
I'm. That's my fired up segment this
Jesus
week.
Jesus Christ.
Why do we have Logan Mayers on the show every goddamn post show? Bullshit. Could have had Corey the Bagel Guy. Could have had Eric Amard. Could have had anybody. Could have had fucking Jocelyn on the show with her hokey pokey, and it would have been more entertaining than this shit. Fuck.
I can't even look at you right now. Logan, I apologize. As I always say, every episode, for all the listeners, all the guests, the opinions of Michael are strictly the opinions of Michael, not those associated with the Slim Pigs Podcast. I can't even talk. You got me over here just, ugh. Logan, go ahead. Your last 2 cents on the New Day. I'm sorry. I will prevent him from cutting you off again. You need to simmer down.
New Day should not have won the match. I think Luke Gallows, Burrow Anderson, it's their time. It's their time to control the tag team division, and I don't know. I think they have something to prove now. You know, can they beat the New Day, and can we take them seriously?
That's a tough question. Is how they've been booked. Michael, can the club be taken seriously at this point? Is it salvageable?
I think I've mentioned this before. I feel like the club definitely needs those belts to stay relevant in the company right now. I feel like they've definitely been underwhelming since they've come on the scene. I think a lot of people expected a lot more than they're getting. Like I said, Carl Anderson.
Okay?
Yeah, sorry, I had a couple belches.
Jesus Christ. All the professionalism on the show for doing shit over again.
What the fuck am I supposed to do?
You know what? I'm fired up since everyone else did it. You know what I'm fired up at? Technology. Go ahead.
Technology is...
Because it always fucks up my shit. Continue.
Quote that, guys, this week. It always fucks up Travis' shit.
Hey, and I'm also sponsored this week by...
fucked up shit?
By an American beer company.
King of beers, Budweiser.
Your king, possibly, not my king.
It's their slogan, not mine.
Very rarely.
It's their slogan, not Logan. But,
Logan's slogan is Michael sucks.
Yeah.
That would be my slogan.
The way you talk
to me if I was Logan, I'd ream you a new asshole. Right up your dirty asshole.
Why does it gotta be dirty? I wash it.
You don't wash it. You're like Bastion Booger.
I wash the shit out of it. It's literally. Good.
I'll tell you one thing, in all seriousness. It's good to be back with you guys finally.
Yeah, you're welcome. You're welcome.
Yeah, Travis, you're welcome.
Jesus Christ, moving right along.
See, he's real creative. Once again, riding my coattails just like you do. I see why this show is where it is. Because of me!
Keep dreaming.
Once again, more entertaining, captivating stuff from Logan Mears. This is how this show goes. Once again, guys, we're going to have a poll this week on who should be the post-show guest.
And if you didn't know, be sure to catch this week on ABC, the season premiere at 9, 8 Central, Secrets and Lies. I'm only saying that because I've been looking at the ad. I should probably put my tab down there.
Yeah.
Click, and then there's Logan.
Hey.
Let's move right along for the tag
team match. Back up.
Now, the CWC is over and done with. Now the guys on the main roster, guys, first ever title defense from TJP, TJ Poikins.
Poikins.
And Brian Kendrick. They gave him about the length of a fucking Divas match. People are not happy with the length of this match, what I've seen initially. They gave the Fatal 4-Way Contendership way more time, but a good little match. Not any fault of the guys in it. Brian Kendrick, Michael, you and I definitely in agreement. He has been way overrated in the CWC tournament. He's done, mm-hmm. I mean, he is one of the oldest guys, but to, like Logan has told us, Tajiri's looked way better than Brian Kendrick. So I kind of feel like
he's not even in the company.
Tajiri should have been in the spot, in my opinion. Straight up, I love Tajiri.
I feel like he could carry a cruiserweight match a lot better than Brian Kendrick at this point in his career. That, like I said before, it feels like it's almost shoved down your throat as an excuse. Like, hey, he's 37 years old.
Yeah.
And he's in the cruiserweight division making his return.
Yeah.
It's like every 5 seconds, hey, he's 37 years old. Like,
we're going to take a commercial break. Brian Kendrick's still 37.
Yeah,
we come back, he may be 38.
Yeah, that's pretty much what you get. Yeah. It's kind of like when Bob Backlund came back.
He was 45 for 2 years.
He was 43 years old for fucking 8 years.
Yeah.
Like, it's.
And they always had to compare to George Foreman. They couldn't think of any other comparison.
Well,
like, no other human being was ever in his 40s and was successful.
At that time, George Foreman was winning the belt. So that's what they compared it to. Oh, you're 43-ish.
Yep.
Well,
like I said, good little match, Michael. Nothing spectacular like we've
TJP
seen.
TJP gets the win.
I like TJP.
His Nintendo music.
Love that music. Yeah. Let's talk about his new 8-bit Mega Man-style entrance music. One of my favorite entrance themes I've ever heard. I love it. I feel like it's a case, though, where the music's definitely going to outshine the performer for me.
Glorious!
I'm waiting.
That's what that makes me think of.
I am waiting.
I feel like the music has definitely outshined Robert Root.
Yeah. It's Bobby. First of all, it's Bobby Root.
Robert is his name, but whatever.
Logan, this match was good for me. It could have been so much more given the length of the time. TJP gets the win with his little knee submission. What'd you think, Logan?
I think TJ Perkins retains the Cruiserweight Championship, but it also left me with some mixed emotions, especially the fact that I guess I expected more and got less. And what Michael and you guys said, I think it's Brian Kendrick. You know, you can't really expect those high-flying moon maneuvers anymore. He's more of a ground-and-pound type guy.
I get it. Hopefully Cedric Alexander. You love you some Rich Swann, too, Michael.
I do like it. I like the charisma. I like that he's from Baltimore, Maryland.
Yeah, I like all the guys in the that they
for those that
up.
Don't know, we are in the Baltimore, Maryland area.
Just want to give them my address, too, while you're
there.
They can come over and murder my
Baltimore,
family.
Baltimore, Maryland's a good ways away from here, but we're in that area.
We're in the vicinity.
Yeah.
So I apologize for jumping down your throat.
Yeah, you should.
I got some
news. I feel like that was uncalled for.
Sonny was in the news this week. Before we
are we going through the news now?
No, we're not even going to do news.
Are we going to do Cesaro and Sheamus like it was planned?
We're going to get to it.
Okay.
Just felt like up. I didn't want to do the exact same show over again and go insane from saying the same things I just said.
No, we're fine.
Well, let's okay.
No.
You want to save it?
Yeah, we'll save it.
Jump in the bark gun.
Yeah. Calm down. Next up, we had the best of 7 series. Cesaro and Sheamus. Tied 3-3. This was the be-all, end-all.
Seven matches with Sheamus.
Travis is very excited about that. Which, if you would have saw when Sheamus came into the fold, when he first came in, Travis's attitude...
You couldn't let that out of the new format for the redo.
Was much different.
Got to get that
When Sheamus came on the scene, you'd have thought he was Jesus. Because
Jesus.
Travis looked at this guy and was like... Oh my God, this guy's awesome.
I literally stood up, I opened a beer, and I said, there's Jesus.
That's pretty much what it felt like.
No, it's not.
That's what I had to deal with you when Sheamus first came on the scene.
He was different.
And then a few months later, he beats John Cena for the belt, and it's like, ha ha, told you, this guy's awesome. And now, 2016's here.
Did I really do that? Did I go, ha ha, told you, and point in your
face? Much.
No, I didn't.
Pretty much.
I don't remember that.
You did.
I don't remember that.
You were pretty intoxicated.
I remember high-fiving with you when Alberto Del Rio ran the Rumble. That may be one of our more embarrassing Celebration Memphis. Remember that? Watched the Royal Rumble 2011.
I mean, we all did the $5 bet.
The 40-man Rumble.
On the blind entrance. Yeah,
that we even was had 2009.
That was the Alberto Del Rio Rumble.
We had them for both. It was at the old, shout out to Jerkface.
Yeah, Jerkface, suck it. Speaking of that, we had a lot of suckets tonight on the show.
We did have a lot of suckets in the main event.
That's even on the format here, a lot of suckets. Never thought that would be on a format for a show.
Yeah, but it was on there. Only on the Slam Picks podcast on a format does it say lots of suckets.
Same thing. Next up, best
Joe Cuties.
We'll get to that later.
We'll get to that.
I know you're chomping at the bit for that one.
Well, Dave Meltzer has an article up where he's one of the most top prospect up and coming referees. So because of all his jiu-jitsu training. So Joe Cuities was a martial arts legend.
Hell of a guy.
And he refereed the main event
tonight. But back to the topic at hand. We had
best
Cesaro.
Best second series. This match was nuts. Go ahead.
Talk about your dive. I know that's what you've been waiting for.
This dive. You didn't even see it. That's why you're just breezing it off. If you would have seen the dive by Cesaro tonight, you wouldn't just be going, brushing it off. You'd be going, Jesus, that was good. I thought the man killed himself. Logan, these guys need to stop.
Do we have to?
What?
Why can't we just keep talking? Why do we need that?
Will you be serious? Why do these guys keep diving?
I have no clue. At this point, after seeing Daniel Bryan and them get hurt, but if you put, like I said, if you put Lita's video when she dove out and broke her neck, it was the same thing between Cesaro and Sheamus tonight. Really scary, really scary. I actually thought he was hurt.
I definitely did. I either thought he was selling it really good or he was hurt. I was waiting up for, not Joe Quixote's, but the other ref to throw up the X.
Mm-hmm.
For the injury. Why are these guys diving, Michael? Like, fucking Luke Harper was injured. Is Braun Strowman going to dive next?
I hope not.
The fuck is going on? Dean Ambrose, stop diving. Rollins' dives didn't even look good.
Dean Ambrose, stop doing everything that you do because it just looks hokey.
And stop dating Renee Young so I can.
Yeah, while you're at it. That too.
Because I got a shot.
Yeah.
Slam Picks podcast, getting his name out there.
Well, maybe she's high like she was the other week. That
was when Del Rio was leaving there having a celebration.
Renee Young, welcome to the
pre-show.
Jesus Christ. Shinsuke.
Let's not go off the rails. This match was really good. I thought it may have stolen the show.
Except for the ending.
The ending.
Did we get a finish, Travis?
We're going 8 matches with Sheamus.
You're excited.
Yep, I guess.
So what happened in the finish of this match?
Finish of this match was a no contest. Both men, apparently, I don't know, I didn't read any of the news before we went live for the second show tonight. Nobody's legit injured, so it was a work. That was the planned finish. They stopped the match. Fans were pissed. I was pissed. Pretty sure we were all pissed. That's what we got out of all this, so. Yeah.
Okay.
Michael.
I think it's permanent break time.
Already?
Yeah.
Let's do it.
What happens?
This is a...
I've been waiting for this promo for a long time. Just came to me tonight. It's a guy that I've been compared to as far as my character. As far as the way that I act in real life. People have compared me to this Hall of Fame great, and I think it's time that we dedicated...
Harley Race.
No.
Oh.
I lied to Travis. No, that's not me.
I want half of my robe blue and the other half red.
And I'm going to wear undies.
Who's your promo?
My promo break is from the great Hall of Famer, one of the four original horsemen, Tully Blanchard.
There you have it. Clean as they come.
Clean as they come promo.
Logan, big Tully Blanchard, four horsemen fan growing up.
Yeah, I like this promo.
Sounds like it.
Yeah, Michael. I didn't see
it. Would it kill you to get a little excited about something on the show?
Say anything without Michael. I swear.
Go right ahead. I want you to. I would find it highly amusing.
The fuck is that?
We are live. We are doing what we do in the hard.
Did your dildo just vibrate while we're trying to do a goddamn show?
We'll be right back.
I Women's Heavyweight Champion, Tully Blanchard, and his perfect 10, Baby Doll.
You know, David Crockett, the only thing I do in life is get dressed quick.
Yep.
You know, I tell you what, Rocky King may someday be a great, great professional wrestler. Today, he's not quite there. You just saw the United States Heavyweight Champion take him apart. But I tell you what, getting back to what we're talking about, the match before mine, Magnum TA, what you did is typical and expected of the former United States Heavyweight Champion. Hey, nobody pulled your string. You just stand there and hold the microphone. Magnum TA, interfering in somebody else's match is the same thing that you and Dusty Rhodes have been doing for a long, long time. You like it. You want matches with no rules. Anything that favors you guys. Well, that's fine. Because I tell you what, the Andersons and myself are ready for any kind of action. Any kind. Whether it be Bunkhouse, Texas Tornado, Texas Death, anything you want to do, because we can get down and be dirty with the dirtiest of them all. But we can also be, ha, as clean as they come. And you notice it, Baby Doll, ha, little cleavage today, baby. Little bit, ha, too much, too much. Sit in your seats there. Don't let your husbands run wild. You keep your eyes off of her, too. Magnum TA, Dusty Rhodes, if you want to be the United States Heavyweight Champion, I'm not hard to find. I'm in the phone book, Jackson Brown. Come and see me.
We'll see you next week on the Best in Professional.
We are back.
Class. That was who?
That was Tully Blanchard. Clean as they come. Right here on the Slam Picks Podcast, Clash of Champions post show, Michael Logan. We're back, guys. Let's get right back into this card. But before we do...
We're not talking about Tully.
I thought we talked about Tully before you made a comment that made me just take the show to break.
Sorry.
Tully Blanchard was great.
I thought that was our best promo ever on this show.
You know, possibly. That's one of my favorite promos.
What do you guys think? Was that our best promo break ever?
How many goddamn polls do you want this week?
I want 7.
You're up to like 4.
Well, that was only
1 poll a week.
That was 2.
By the end of the show, you pick.
That was only 2.
You can only have 1.
It's only 2.
You can only have 1.
This is 2 right now.
But I only want 1.
Jesus fucking Christ. See, I say we're the most interactive podcast on the internet by far.
We answer.
And you want to limit the shit.
And I'm getting right into that right now.
For fuck's sake.
First question in forever.
No, Michael. We're not doing that.
What?
We have to go down the card.
Because I discussed this with Logan during the break while you had to get another beer so you can do the show. Huh?
Oh, really? We want to go into that? Name me all the stars that had to have a few beers after a show or during a show.
I didn't say there's anything wrong with it.
Exactly.
But they had a mini fridge beside them at least. They didn't have to leave the studio.
It's not my fault.
Now I'm fired up second week in a row. That is not even a fridge. It's a stand.
Yeah.
It's a stand.
Why are you pointing at it like it's a fridge?
I pointed over there. I didn't point over there.
There's
a hell of a lot of difference from there to there.
What's over here?
Space. Time and space. And
why don't you get a fucking mini fridge down here so I don't have to walk upstairs?
Pay my electricity bill.
Jesus. Fucking Christ.
Possibly.
Can we get back into the card?
I want to get to this question because Logan wants to answer. Because it's going to get him fired up. He already told me up there, would you like to see Logan fired up? Everybody else would have got fired up. Logan, are you ready for this question from the lovely Melody?
Yes, I'm ready for it.
Don't be scared. You can say you're ready for it like a man.
First of all, yes, I'm ready. Guys, any questions? Questions, leave down in the comments below. In all seriousness, thank you, Melody. You want to thank Melody?
Is it Melody or Melanie?
Okay. It says Melody.
Okay.
She's a big Rollins fan.
Oh,
she's
good.
Like obsessed,
like
borderline.
We should do it.
Her question this week, I just watched SmackDown. I'm really pissed. I'd like to know what you guys think of John Cena being able to just waltz back in and being handed the title opportunity. Am I just being bitchy or is this what the WWE Universe really wants? I'm not being bitchy about it because I don't like Cena. It's just I don't think it's okay for him to get a title shot right now. I'm on board. This is more of wanting you guys' opinions, I guess, than a question for your show, but it seemed like questions. So yeah. She wanted an answer on the show. So thank you, Melanie. Who's going first? Russian roulette.
Let fucking Logan go.
Logan.
Before I get fired up about this, I will tell you the reason why he's been thrown into this championship match and feud is because they don't have many stars on SmackDown. They need to add more big names because, of course, they have other feuds going on. But I am fired up. You know what? John Cena should not be in this match. I think they should be. This is the new era, and they're making it seem like it's the John Cena era on SmackDown. John Cena, go back to doing your little co-hosting. Okay, go do that. I mean, you're basically The Rock 2.0 when it comes to, oh, I don't do movies, you know, but you're doing TV shows and you're doing all this. Go co-host, because I'm sick and tired of seeing the same thing over and over again. I mean, what's next? No Mercy, John Cena wins the WWE World Champion? Really? I'm done with John Cena.
Yeah, I agree. But I have a bad feeling they're going to do it, because he has been mentioning it in promos that talk about that 16th tie in the record.
We've already talked about this. Yeah. It's inevitable. It's
Melanie, yes, I think it is bullshit. They want to say it's a new era. I was so happy when it seemed like it would be Ambrose and Styles, and I'm always happy when Cena's out of the title picture in any era situation. I just, why? They need to make new stars, and they'd have more stars if they would have spent more time making them, as opposed to the John Cena Roman Reigns fucking show for years.
Okay, whoa. I think you're being a little too... Look at all the new stars we have just in the past couple years.
They're all on Raw. Raw is stacked with all the...
Well, I'm just saying, you're acting like WWE hasn't made any new stars.
Dean
Ambrose, who was your champion. He's a new star, right?
There is no reason Sami Zayn and Kevin Owens should be on the same show. They blew off their feud, and now Sami Zayn is losing to Chris fucking Jericho.
We'll get to that.
I love Jericho, but it's a new era.
We haven't got to that yet. We're to get ahead of ourselves.
About to here in a second, so it's a good segue. Raw's lopsided. Logan, do you think Raw's
But Raw's also 3 hours.
I said Logan. I didn't say Michael.
When do I get a fucking opinion on this
show? How does it feel to have your knees cut off?
Here we fucking go. Go ahead. Go ahead, Logan. Go ahead, Mr. Mears. Let's hear all your fucking stunning opinions.
I think I know what Michael's going to say. You know, 3 hours, I mean, they need the star power because they have that extra hour.
No, they don't, because they just brought up the Cruiserweight division. Why not make maybe not a whole hour of Raw, but make it kind of seem like it's not all one long show? You got the Cruiserweight division. You can easily fill up an hour with two Cruiserweight matches. They've done it for weeks. That's why I call bullshit on there's 3 hours.
I think you already said that before, though.
And now they're treating them like Divas matches.
You said that Vince didn't want to overshadow his main event matches.
That's the word on the street and the rumors. Vince McMahon does not... He wants to tone back the Cruiserweight Classic in-ring competition because of fear of outshining the main event level guys. But I think, man, they brought up the Cruiserweights to have them do piss-break Diva matches, it kind of seems. It sucks.
But the sad part is, even if you tone down the Cruiserweight, they're still going to overshine them in some aspect.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah?
That was it, huh?
We'll see, Michael.
That was that great analysis from Logan. That was it?
Your thoughts on Melody's question, Michael.
Oh, I can have a turn?
Yes, because I threw it to you, because I'm the host.
Oh, so now you're fucking Adolf Hitler of the goddamn show.
Really? Why does I always have to be fucking Chris Benoit, Adolf Hitler, Jesus Christ, who's next? Jack Kevorkian?
You definitely want to be a dictator on
who's
this
another murderer?
Show.
Fucking...
Just saying.
God. John Wayne Gacy?
Who's that?
John Wayne Gacy?
I'm just fucking with you. But, I mean, you definitely kind of get into a dictator mood sometimes on this show, and it's
you
a little
have
offensive.
No choice but to make
little
me fire
offensive.
Up. I'm sponsored
I'm
this
a little
week.
Offended. Can I have a turn? Is
I
that all right with
I've
you, sir?
I turn it to you for
sir,
going on 2 minutes now.
Sir, can I have a turn?
Sure. Please kill
are
the dead
you,
air.
Are you going to stop talking?
Now who's boring, Logan?
Am I ever going to get to start talking without you talking? Okay. Now I'm going to start talking. First of all...
Your hair's messy.
I have a fucking hat on. That made no fucking sense.
Just fucking do it.
Yeah.
Jesus Christ.
First of all, Raw is 3 hours. SmackDown is 2 hours. That's why it's lopsided as far as rosters. As far as new stars being made, I feel like there's been more new stars.
Well, no, that's not her question. That's not her question.
But I was rebutting your comment, Toka. Okay? I will get to her question. Okay. But as far as your comment on, yes, you disagree because there's not enough new stars on SmackDown, I feel like this is the exact point on why the brands were split. Okay, this is to make new stars, just like you had in the first main event for SmackDown was in SummerSlam, you had Dolph Ziggler in your main event for the title. Okay, you had Dolph Ziggler and Dean Ambrose. for the strap. So, as far as your point goes, not enough new stars being made. I think in the last 2 or 3 years, WWE has made more new stars than they did in the previous 10.
Then why are they relying on John Cena?
John Cena, it's not. Back to I don't think they're relying on John Cena.
It's really?
I don't think it's relying. I think it's just, it makes sense because John Cena and AJ Styles were feuding before John Cena left.
I get.
Okay. And AJ Styles is the champ. Okay. They have Dean Ambrose in the match because he was the champ that AJ Styles took the strap off of. So I don't think it, to answer her question, I get it. I understand why you're frustrated. But I think this was a question probably more suited for about
two, three years ago
when Cena was in a main event for no fucking reason.
Do you think Cena's going to win at No Mercy?
No.
You don't think he's going to
get it? I don't. I think Styles retains.
Logan, do you think Cena's going to get the belt at No Mercy?
No, I don't think he will. But I want to say something, Michael. To be honest with you, John Cena lost twice to AJ Styles. Why does he deserve to be in the championship match?
That's what I was actually going to say. I was really serious about to come back at you with that.
Why does he deserve to be in the championship match?
Because it's John Cena, is that what you're going to say?
Well, no, it's not because it's John Cena, but because
he's the face that runs that little place.
Are you good there? Jesus Christ, you just went on a little. What was that?
Let's move on.
He's the face that runs that little place.
Like, are you now right? You just did it.
I feel like you just poked fun at some people in there.
What?
Sexual views.
Oh, will you be serious? It was a voice. Okay. I have many of friends.
Okay.
Shout out to Tasha, listeners, so thank you very much.
All right, I feel like it was kind of insulting.
It was just, sometimes I get in that little voice.
Oh, okay.
You do it too.
All right, JR.
Fucking hypocrite.
Calm down.
Goddamn JBO over here.
You're fucking JR over here.
What?
Jesus Christ.
Now who's
don't you
fun
ever talk about Craig the Hammer Valentine like that.
Oh, God.
But anyway, I feel like John Cena got the title shot because it adds another dynamic to this feud. I feel like it has nothing to do. What are you laughing at?
Why do you guys?
You all right?
Apologies, I just hit the mic. We're back.
Okay.
Sorry.
I feel like this adds another dynamic to the feud because you have AJ Styles, who just took the belt off of the former champ, Dean Ambrose, and AJ Styles also just coming off a feud with John Cena that really wasn't. You just saw Cena kind of exit. You didn't see, like, the traditional where the babyface comes back to finally take over the heel.
Yeah.
That's why Cena's in this match. I don't feel like it's in the match for him to win it. I feel like I shouldn't say Styles retains. I think Dean Ambrose wins this match.
You think he gets it back already?
I think Dean Ambrose wins this match because of somewhere or another, I feel like Styles and Cena, it's either going to be Styles or Ambrose, okay? There's no way that Cena wins this match. Okay. I'm going to go ahead and say that up front. Anybody that disagrees with me, that's fine, but I would be willing to bet the farm that John Cena does not win this match at the pay-per-view. I would bet my unborn child that John Cena does not win the strap at this pay-per-view.
I think Styles retains.
It doesn't make any sense. It's either going to be Styles or Ambrose. I could definitely see Ambrose winning the belt back and Styles and Cena going back into their feud. And I could definitely see Styles retaining the belt to where maybe Ambrose moves out of the feud and in with someone else, and then it's Styles and Cena for the belt. But I definitely don't see any way why it would make sense to make John Cena the champion right now, as far as booking wise. But to answer Melody's question, that's why he's being put in this match. I understand what you're feeling. We've been feeling this for years as wrestling fans.
Yeah.
Why does John Cena keep getting put in certain spots? But in this sense, I will actually defend Cena. It makes sense. He was in a feud with the current champion when he left. So when he comes back, it would only make sense for him to avenge that loss to the current champion.
Plus, trying to understand their logic, yeah. WWE is trying to understand something ridiculous.
Melody, I definitely feel your pain. I think we all do. I think your thoughts are definitely...
Very many people's.
Yes.
Yes. We get it.
But please, if you could bet, if Vegas did sports betting as far as WWE, I would bet my whole entire life savings that John Cena does not come out of this match as a new champ.
Well, there you have it. Thank you, Melody. I hope you got the answer you're looking for. Well, let's move right along into this paper. You guys always send us a question. We're the most what
interactive podcast on the internet by far. I think they know what we talk about. I don't feel like I have to say wrestling.
Chris Jericho, drink it in, man.
Drink it.
Stupid idiots.
Chug it.
Versus Sami Zayn. Guys.
For a the one match on the card, well, I guess there's two matches on the card where there was no title involved in a card that was all about championships being defended.
Also, no Enzo and Cass, unless they were on the pre-show.
Yeah, I thought they would be. They were on the pre-show against the Shining Stars.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. Yeah.
Logan, what'd you think of the Jericho Sami Zayn match?
I called it before the match even happened that Chris Jericho was going to win this match, and I see why he won this match. I think it was an entertaining match. I think Chris Jericho doesn't need to win or lose, really. Can we all agree on that? Jericho doesn't need to win or lose. It's the in-ring performances that will shine the most. And I think he doesn't need to lose to Sami Zayn to make Sami Zayn look good. And he doesn't need to lose or win against Sami to make Sami look, you know, really good. I think this match was
So you agreed with who won this match?
So you agree who won the match then, Logan? Chris Jericho?
I agree. I think Chris Jericho should have won this match.
Michael, did the right man go over tonight?
No.
I don't either.
I think Sami Zayn is suffering from that old Dean Ambrose syndrome. Like, yes, he did beat Kevin Owens, but how many times does Sami Zayn get put in a match or a feud where he actually comes out on top?
Yeah.
Like when?
Very rarely.
This seemed like a tailor-made situation. Aging, formidable star against younger, up-and-coming star. Who should go over?
But play devil's advocate on that. See the other side. Chris Jericho has gotten himself over more now lately than he has forever. He's doing some of his best work.
Is there maybe a feud down the line with Kevin Owens?
Well, I could see that. And I could see.
Is that where they're going?
And I could see that leading to Chris Jericho taking time off, like doing an injury angle to do Fozzy stuff.
Okay. So well, is Fozzy even still together?
No. Yeah.
He's been in WWE for a good year now straight.
I don't know. I'm not.
Yeah. Like, obviously, that band had, like, I think he's talked about, like, playing in front of crowds of this big. Were you the headliner? No. You were the opening act. So let's stop acting like you were some kind of major rock star.
Well, maybe I'll throw a Fozzy song on the show this week.
Please don't. I've heard them. They're not good.
I totally agree with you.
I think that Sami Zayn should have went over.
Yep.
If you're talking about a new era, you have a new star against an aging vet. Not to say that Jericho can't work. Jericho can still work almost to the best of his ability back when he was in his prime. I don't feel like Jericho has lost as much as a lot of top stars over their career as far as when they age. But I think a lot of that can be attributed to the breaks that he's taken with the Fozzy and all that stuff.
Yeah.
But I definitely think Sami Zayn should have went. Maybe he will at the next pay-per-view. Maybe they have some sort of, hopefully not a Hell in a Cell match. Because it would make no fucking sense. What are they fighting for? There's nothing to fight for in this match except for pride. So why can't Zayn go over in this feud? I just don't get it.
I think at the end of the day, it boils down to Chris Jericho losing won't hurt Chris Jericho at this stage in his career. It could hurt Sami Zayn in the fans' eyes.
And Chris Jericho would.
Exactly. So
how does that make sense?
There you have it, Logan.
I don't think it hurt Sami Zayn.
You don't? Why?
Because I feel like, okay, you know how back in the day, when Christian, for example, you know, he didn't need to win and he didn't need to lose to get over, and he didn't need to win or lose to look good.
Was Christian a top-level talent, though?
No, but I'm saying, like, Sami Zayn's not going to be a top guy, I don't think.
What, could have said that about Kevin Owens a year ago.
I think you're totally wrong there.
I would have called Sami Zayn being a top guy way before Kevin Owens.
I think in less than 2 years, Sami Zayn's wearing that strap.
I think Sami Zayn has Daniel Bryan syndrome where he's the ultimate underdog.
Absolutely.
I just think Sami Zayn is too good to, right now in the ring, that he didn't need to beat Jericho. But I think this is a one-off thing because about a couple weeks ago, after the Backlash pre pre-show that we did, I read that the report was that before Finn Balor got hurt, at Hell in a Cell was supposed to be Kevin Owens, Finn Balor, and Chris Jericho in a triple threat Hell in a Cell for the Universal Championship match.
So, what? I don't get it.
I think that he's saying that was going to lead to Jericho and Owens having a feud. So he can probably see Jericho and Owens having a feud.
So, what? As far as booking wise, who? I mean, I get that they're friends right now.
Why is the wind out of your sails also?
Well, I just don't think it, and it. I'm not going to go there. But it just doesn't make
sense. Let's go there.
We're back.
People want us to go there.
It doesn't make sense booking-wise right now. Or I think any time for Kevin Owens and Chris Jericho to go against each other for the title.
I think it makes sense booking-wise how they book them as best friends. I can see. It's because Jericho.
Is Chris Jericho believable to win that championship?
No, but he's a perfect example of what we talked about earlier, an established veteran putting a guy over, just like with Brian Kendrick.
Yeah, but
Jericho can work.
Who is going to tune in if they don't have the network? Who is going to buy the network to watch Kevin Owens and Chris Jericho fight for the strap?
Would that even main event that show?
That's what I'm saying, and that's your champion right now, and that's what I'm saying as far as
I don't know
his thoughts on that. That's why I don't think it makes any sense.
We'll see where it goes.
I mean, I know that Kevin Owens and Sami Zayn just came off a feud. And all that. So now you have the world, you have your champion, okay? And the guy that he just came off a feud with before winning the title is losing to Chris Jericho. Clean. Clean in the center of the ring. So how does that really make your champion look when his last clean victory is over a guy that couldn't even beat an aging vet?
Well, they're not booking him clean either. He got a cheap win tonight, but we'll get to that.
It wasn't a cheap win. Kinda. I mean, did somebody cheat
Jericho
for him?
Jericho interfered.
Well, Jericho interfered, but that was long before the finish.
Well, we'll get it. Let's move the show along, because it's getting late, guys. Women's Raw Championship, Michael. Triple threat. Charlotte. Flatty.
Pretty sure I predicted this one right.
Michael called this from the get. Charlotte retains against Sasha Banks and Bayley. Let's get right down to the match, guys. There was a great moonsault spot you fell in love with, Michael.
Loved it. I thought that moonsault spot on both of them was perfect. As far as a dangerous move goes, that was the epitome of a dangerous move. You have two people laying there, not just one, to do a moonsault on. And she did it on two people, and it was landed perfectly. Nobody got hurt. And it looked great. I thought it looked great. What did you think of the moonsault?
I thought it looked good. Yeah, definitely.
Now, as far as the knee stomp onto Bayley's stomach,
which
where Charlotte
make sense
was on,
to
yeah,
do in the
that spot place. Was kind of hokey. There were some problems in this match, but I thought I was really happy that they gave them some time. They got almost 20 minutes, didn't they?
Yeah.
Yeah.
They got more time than the Cruiserweights.
Yeah. I mean, this is what we were clamoring about before, though. Let's give these new era women some time.
I think they should both have
now,
equal time.
Now we're getting it,
yeah.
And the Cruiserweights aren't getting it. So, I mean, it's kind of like feast or famine, like pick your poison.
Yeah.
Like, obviously, if I was going to pick between a Cruiserweight match and a women's title match, I'm probably going to pick Cruiserweights. But that's just because it's more aesthetically pleasing to my eye than...
What?
Yeah.
What did you just say?
Aesthetically pleasing.
It's more aesthetically pleasing to your eye to watch men wrestle instead of women.
Yeah. It's more fun for me to watch.
Okay, but not aesthetically pleasing would mean
more
something else.
It's more pleasing for me to watch Cruiserweights than it
but
is.
But not aesthetically, because that means it's based off how they look, is what I'm saying.
It definitely. I think a Cruiserweight match looks a lot better than a women's
match. Yeah, in ring-wise, but let's clarify what you meant. I just didn't want people...
See, again,
I didn't want to hop him. No, I'm actually got your back, because I don't want Bruce Biggs to come on and give you a shot.
Who the fuck is Bruce Biggs?
Bruce Biggs.
Have we heard from him in the last 2 months?
He's hopped on out of here.
I think he learned his lesson.
Just saying, you never know. People in the internet trolls are sneaky.
Once again,
man.
You're making more comments towards a certain community that could get you in trouble.
I am not.
Yeah, that's
I just
two.
Wanted to make sure.
Two.
Here we
tonight.
Go.
That's two. That's strike two. Well,
and it's also documented how ass you're being.
I just
wanted to save you the trouble clarifying that up.
I mean, I know what aesthetically means. So
this match, it could have been way better, in my opinion.
Well, I don't think it was great. I mean, what did I give it? I gave it a B+, right?
Something like that.
And that was you know, generous for me, but I thought that the three women involved did a good job. Not a great job. I felt like the match could have been more. I felt like if it was on NXT, they would have gotten a lot more time.
Yeah.
I feel like this was a little bit rushed and kind of saved. Like, a lot of the moves were kind of rushed into a five-minute period. I feel like...
Baby. You think Bayley's been suffering from some main roster jitters? She doesn't look like she's herself a lot.
Well, I don't know if it's that or just the style of a WWE main roster match. I know that people say that
Dusty Rhodes.
Yes, that people say.
People say, baby.
But I know that people say, well, NXT is WWE, so I don't see why it would be. It's a totally different style match when you watch NXT. Time.
Yeah.
Well, it's a totally different style match. You like we said before, Triple H is running the show on NXT.
Yep.
He's not running the show on the main roster. So you're going to have a totally different style match in NXT than you would on the main roster. Now, if they would have put an NXT-style match on tonight on the main this would have stole the show.
Yeah.
But I don't feel like they were allowed to do that. I feel like there might have been a couple spots where somebody in the back might have said, we might not want to do that because, you know, somebody could get hurt and we just don't want the card to flounder because somebody's had a big injury.
Yep.
But I totally understand the people also that might say that this match was underwhelming. I gave it a B+ because I thought it was good for what it was.
I'm pretty sure Logan's fired up again, though, about this match.
I don't give two shits, but let's ask.
I'm fired up because I don't want to see Charlotte with the championship anymore. I think I understand why they put it back on Charlotte after Sasha Banks got injured and because they didn't know the timetable of her, you know, injury and if she was going to be out. But I'm fired up because I'm tired of seeing the whole Dana Brooke. I mean, what reason is there to have Dana Brooke out there anymore? You know, she slapped Charlotte a couple weeks ago on Raw, and then now she's just, oh, I'm going to carry your bags. That's stupid garbage. Now, guys, I wanted to tell you something. Because my brother showed me this on Instagram.
That's all.
Literally right after the women's match tonight. He said, people think that Dana Brooke and Charlotte is the 2.0 of Michelle McCool and Layla.
I wouldn't give him that much credit. Lay Cool were more. Lay Cool were better as a pair, I think.
You loved Lay Cool.
They had more chemistry.
You're one of eight people in the world that love Lay Cool.
I don't love Lay Cool. You want a Lay Cool promo break when I'm
my turn? Please don't. Oh, it's a good way to lose listeners.
But no, if you guys didn't know, I'm a big fan of Bayley, and I have a huge crush on Bayley.
You would.
Shut up, Michael, because I know you're going to say some smart-ass comment.
She looks like a man.
That's Charlotte.
Bayley has a big old man nose.
Well, can we not judge the women based on their looks? Can we not do that on this show? We're talking about the in-ring competition.
And Travis loves some Charlotte, so when you say Charlotte looks like a man, you're hurting his feelings, not mine. Right, Travis?
I like Charlotte. I mean, honestly, if we're being completely honest, I don't... The only one I'd turn away in the women's division is Nia Jax. So let's keep it real.
I'd move right along. I'd do her.
Somebody's got to.
Turn the light off. Beauty's only a light switch away, baby.
Well, let's not completely go there on the show.
But then again, the hottest person in this whole match, regardless, I think it's undeniable, Sasha Banks is the hottest woman in this match.
There's our review. No she's argument. The hottest.
Yeah. No argument there. She didn't win the match, but she's definitely the most sexy.
Well, Logan, what would you grade this match?
I would give this match a C, and the only reason why is because I actually agree with Michael. You know, if they did a NXT style match, I think it would have been an A or a B, but it just wasn't the case. They wasn't given enough time, I think.
It definitely wasn't given enough time, but I could definitely see why it was the kind of match it was. as far as that goes, I don't... A C, really, Logan?
I'll give it a C.
Why?
Because I think it was a decent triple threat.
But you gave it a C. Like, would you... You watch how many indie matches, and you're giving this match a C?
Okay, then what would you grade it, Michael?
I gave it a B plus.
Time restraints. I just think I gave it a C. If it was given more time, I would have given it a higher grade.
Okay.
I'm not saying anything about the performers at all. I think those three women are freaking talented. Needed more time, honestly.
All right, I guess I see where you're going, but I just feel like a C was kind of like an East German judge there a little bit. As far as that match goes, we all know what the problem was. They weren't allowed, I don't think, to do the style of match that they should have been allowed to do. I don't feel like it's their fault, but it's just the way the business works. On the main roster, you do the style of match that you're told to do. And if you don't do that, you will have your bags packed. That's just the way it works. There's many a superstar that have gone against the grain, and there's many that have been pushed out the door. That's just the way the world works these days. But then again, that's the world in general, not just in WWE. Logan, as far as this match here, as far as the women go, who do you think should have been champion?
I think Sasha Banks should have won this. I really do. I think it's too soon for Bayley, but I'm just tired of seeing Charlotte.
Okay, I agree with you there. I think we definitely agree that it's too soon for Bayley. Where I disagree is I think it made more sense for Charlotte to hold the belt other than Sasha Banks, because then with Sasha losing the belt just to win it back less than a month later, I feel like that could have been kind of like, really, what was the point of that? Travis said, well, they thought her injury was more serious than it really was, but I still think booking-wise, to put it back on Sasha that soon would not have made a whole lot of sense.
But I do want to say something, though. I think they see dollar signs and Dana Brooke. I really do. I think that's going to be a feud between her and Charlotte that's going to bump Dana Brooke up in the division. I can see her taking the belt off Charlotte before anybody else.
I totally disagree with that. I think Dana Brooke is a big old shitbag that will never wear that belt. If she ever does, that just totally takes all the steam out of their new women's revolution. Yeah. I feel like that would just be a total waste. I think Dana Brooke is limited at best in the ring, and I think she's limited at best as far as a character. I think Dana Brooke is a total shitbag. Sorry.
I'm not saying I want to see it happen. I just think for some odd reason, the way they're pushing the whole Dana Brooks and Charlotte, you know, the issues that between them, I think some odd reason, I think that's going to happen.
Travis, your thoughts on Dana Brooke?
I think putting the belt on her, in my eyes, would be the same as putting it on Eva Marie on SmackDown. I don't think anybody wants either. I actually argue with people on Twitter all the time about Eva Marie. People are into her character. Yeah, she's over. Do you hear the heel heat she gets? It's not heel heat. It's fucking X-Pac heat. Get off my television. No, it doesn't. First of all, I thought it was going to go back to Sasha tonight since she was cleared and not obviously injured anymore, but they didn't. Yeah, I'm ready for it to come off Charlotte, too. She's starting to come off like Nikki Bella in a way.
I see, that's where I disagree with you.
Well, better in-ring, but kind of like...
It didn't make any sense for her to lose it tonight, as far as I'm concerned. I felt like it was too soon for Sasha to win it back, and it was definitely too soon for Bayley to win it.
Speaking of someone that shouldn't have won something, United States title match, guys. Let's get right into
it. Well, I mean, he already did his fired up segment.
We already did fired up. Rusev. Defending that little belt against...
That little U.S. belt.
That little U.S. belt.
It used to mean so much.
Against Roman Reigns with Lana, who was ejected from ringside, Michael. Standard. Oh, you said
this. Can Lana work?
She has wrestled, but she's not very good.
No, well,
she's kind of like Lay Cool.
What if we gave her a year to work, like on her own, before we brought her in? Because
they gave Eva Marie a year being trained by Brian Kendrick.
Yeah, I think
that turned out.
Well, we haven't seen. I think Lana unquestionably is the best looking woman on the WWE television screen. Period. Lana.
Are you talking about her going for the women's belt, possibly?
Well, I mean, that's why I'm wondering, like, what kind of talent she might have in the ring. Like, could she possibly work in the future? That's why I'm asking, like, because I would much rather watch her with that belt than I would rather watch Charlotte. I mean, Charlotte can work. I get it. But Charlotte...
But you're judging it based on appearance. Well, they're not doing that anymore. It's in-ring.
WWE's all about your look. Look at Roman Reigns. He won the U.S. belt tonight.
That's... Yeah.
Whether it's male or female, Charlotte, they're all about the look.
You guys say she looks like a man. Charlotte isn't ugly. I think Charlotte's really...
She's not ugly, beautiful. But I think below the waist, she looks totally like a man. She has no hips. She has no ass. She walks like a man. She walks like she has a penis.
Well...
I'm just saying.
She walks like Chet Stedman.
Well, yeah. He's got that cheddar.
Does she look like Gary Busey?
He's a rocket.
You want to put that poll up? Poll number 5.
She might actually, if you think about it.
Cut her hair.
Take the mustache off of Gary Busey.
Put a Cubs hat on her head.
Take a mustache off of Gary Busey and put him on there.
Guys, what did you think of this United States title match? I mean, the whole
build-up. I think I told you as soon as the match was over. I think I even told you before the match was over that... What sense did this make booking wise? Did Rusev ever go over in this feud at all?
Did he, Logan?
I don't believe he did.
Clear my throat a little bit.
So what was the point of this feud, other than to give Roman the U.S. belt? So where
I'll tell you the point. It's always the point of any feud: make Roman look strong.
Okay, so where does Rusev go from here? I mean, I don't understand. He was built and built and built as this strong heel. That gets over and just dominates everybody. And then he goes against Roman Reigns for a couple months. I don't think he won a match. Other than maybe it was there a DQ that he won or a count out. He never went over. He never went over strong in this whole feud. It's kind of like it's, at least when Bray Wyatt was with Cena, Bray Wyatt went over at one of the pay-per-views. You know what I mean? Rusev has
still
not...
Still turned out shit for Wyatt.
Yeah, Rusev did not go over in this whole feud. Made no sense to me for this. Like, and especially for a guy that just came off a 30-day suspension for violating the wellness policy. Well, this is your punishment. I'm going to give you the U.S. belt.
Yep.
That makes sense. Other than a guy like Rusev, who's been a stand-up guy since he came in the company, does what he's told. He works, as far as his size, I think pound for pound, other than Cesaro,
yeah.
I feel like he's one of the best workers in this company. And I don't feel like he's being treated the way he should be treated as far as booking-wise. I feel like Rusev could be a top-level heel as far as the main event picture, not just the U.S. picture. Maybe that's where they're going, hopefully.
He had a lot of heat, and he probably still does, when he and Lana posted pictures of their engagement.
Yeah.
But that was during the angle when Lana was with Ziggler.
Yeah.
So that pissed a lot of people off, and they pushed him with that stupid League of Nations shit, which hopefully we never have to
it
talk about
It just doesn't
again.
Make sense. Like, what does Rusev have to do to be made to look good against somebody other than the jobber?
It's pro wrestling, though, man. It's politics. It's who
I don't
they
get
like.
It. Like, yeah. Rusev, you look at Rusev, he's built like a
they
brick shithouse.
They don't see dollar signs in him,
Why?
Obviously.
He's built like a brick shithouse. He's one of the best workers in the company. He's over as a heel. Why can't he be in your main event picture if not winning that belt? I don't get it.
Why, like, Logan?
Is it because he's foreign and his accent?
Is that why, Logan?
You know, I agree with Michael. I think Rusev is really talented. I think he's I think he should be pushed to the main event picture here soon, because they're gonna have to add some people into that feud instead of the same couple guys. Because obviously, you know where they're going with the Seth Rollins Triple H thing. So who's gonna feud with Kevin Owens? I mean,
Not another heel. So it wouldn't make sense for Rusev.
I think it would make more sense for Jericho.
But like I said, is anybody really going to... If they haven't bought the network yet, is that really going to make somebody want to buy the network? Because you have to put that deposit down for 6 months. Is that really going to make you want to get it?
I don't know. What is it... What Rusev do wrong to be delegated to... To losing to Roman Reigns tonight.
Again.
You know, I don't even really want to talk about it because it's just going to piss me off even more.
Well, we have a new United States champion.
Roman Reigns wins clean with the spear in the middle of the ring after Lana was already kicked out for saving Rusev from a spear earlier in the match.
Yep.
It's still the end of the match. So, first of all, what was the point of having Lana kicked out for it if it's just going to happen again later in the match, like booking-wise? Like, what kind of psychology are you building?
Yeah.
Basically, all you did was make Rusev look even worse. So it's...
They have to make Roman Reigns strong. Like, That's all they want to do.
I'm not in the wrestling business. I get it. People can call me a smark or whatever they want to call me. But as far as in-ring psychology and all that stuff, what kind of story were they trying to tell in this match that really benefited Rusev at all?
It was asinine from the get-go in this feud. What did this match kind of make you feel like when Roman came out of it, the United States champion, considering he was the WWE champion earlier this year?
That's what I think it's what I told you. It kind of gave me the feeling like it's kind of like when Roman won the U.S., it kind of gave me that feeling back in the early 2000s when you had Stone Cold and Triple H and you had Triple H as the IC champ.
The two-man power trip.
Yeah, that's what it kind of made me feel like, except it's Roman as the U.S. champ instead of Triple H as the IC champ. That's what it made me feel like. I don't know if that's how other people feel.
No, I totally agree. U.S. title and the IC title should go on up and coming, guys. It's like back in the day, the IC title was a test run to see how guys would do with the big one. You don't go backwards. They're giving
a former world champion.
And they did when they did it with Cena.
The U.S. belt. Yeah.
I'll say something positive about Cena on this.
He put guys over. I mean, he won.
But it made Kevin Owens, Sami Zayn, all those guys. What are they going to do with Roman with the belt now, guys? That's the question. Where does Roman go?
Does Roman really have the talent or ability to put guys over like Cena did?
I think he does. I think he does.
Like, I definitely don't see him doing the U.S. Open Challenge, but where does Roman go from? I mean, maybe Rusev gets his rematch here, wins the strap back. Maybe that's when he gets his time to be over. But it's at this point, they've been going at it for, what, 3 months now?
Yeah.
And he still hasn't gone over. So what gives me the idea that he might go over either tomorrow on Raw or any time in the future?
Last year, guys, Night of Champions last year, Seth Rollins was both the WWE and United States champion.
Yeah.
He defended both of those belts. So who's to say that it can't be Roman and Kevin Owens? Since Roman technically beat him on Raw, he should be the number one contender. Winner gets both belts. Logan, can you see that as a possibility?
Please, God, no.
I hope not. I really hope not.
Well, this if was. Ocean,
then it's frustrating. It'd be really frustrating for a lot of fans who are big fans of Roman Reigns.
This was definitely the one book in this whole pay-per-view that
made absolutely no sense. None. You thought that Rusev would have got his for looking so weak in the feud.
Even if he got over dirty, he gets over. You know what I mean? He hasn't gone over in this whole... Even if you remember, even when he attacked Reigns on Raw not that long ago, he attacked Reigns after he just had a long match, and Reigns still beat the ever-loving shit out of him.
End of the day, it's all about the action figures, video games, merchandise. That's their guy. Yeah, that's the guy they want to take over John Cena's spot. We just have to live with it and eat shit. It sucks, but I agree.
They had a match where he's defending his wife's honor. He still gets beat clean. They had him.
Well, he's a heel. He's not supposed to come out the hero. Let's be real.
Yeah, but can he ever go over?
It'll happen on.
That's what makes a feud. How was this a feud at all?
Maybe they'll have a rematch and get his belt back.
So,
who knows?
So Rusev's whole going over in this whole feud was costing Roman Reigns the big belt. That was all.
We'll see tomorrow night on Raw what they do with the gentleman. before we get to the main event,
totally pissed off about that.
Well, let's cheer up.
If I could have a
bit.
Fire up segment, it would have been like Logan. I would have been fired up about this.
Both about Roman Reigns.
Yes, because this made no sense to me. It was because I disagree with Roman having the United States Championship.
How it was executed.
Yes, I totally disagree with the booking.
Well,
they have all these writers, and none of them can come up with something better.
Too many cooks in the kick. Too many cooks in that kitchen, Logan, as far as the writing team.
Yes, and it's pretty bad that I'm more invested in The Miz right now than what Roman Reigns is.
Huh, I feel the same way. Well, let's cheer up a little bit, Michael, because I know this is exciting news. Before we get to the main event, debut of a new official tonight, son of Mike Chiodes, legendary longtime referee, Michael.
It's Mike Chioda.
Mike Chioda. We say Chiodes.
Yeah, we say Chiodes.
Joe Chioda, longtime martial
Joe
artist,
Chiodes.
Made his referee debut tonight. He goes by Joe Chiodes on the MMA scene.
Yep.
Old Chiodes, man. He kept up in ring. He
was definitely a little lost there in a couple spots.
You could tell he was an MMA fighter debuting. You could tell he got the job because his dad was a ref.
Yep, Joe Chiodes made his debut tonight in the main event.
We met Joe Chiodes.
We met him at a local show not too long ago.
Yeah.
It was maybe a year ago?
It was actually a local Tough Man competition.
Yeah, and that dude was a bad motherfucker.
So shout out to Joe Chiodes.
Joe Chiodes was your referee in the main event tonight. Logan, did you know that?
No, I did not.
Yeah, Joe Chiodes, also known as Joe Chioda.
Joe Chioda.
Yeah, he made his debut tonight as the ref of the main event. He definitely looked a little lost at times in there, but when it was time for him to go out, he definitely sold it well.
He was a great fighter, though. But guys, look him up on YouTube, Joe Chioda. Well, look up Chiodes.
Chiodes. How's that spelled, Travis?
Kyodez. Deez.
Two E's, okay.
Yeah. So check out Joe Chiodes. Did a great job. The main event. WWE Universal Championship. It's time, guys. Kevin Owens, champion, defending against, in your opinion, the man, Seth Rollins.
Seth Rollins.
Logan, kick this off. What did you think of the match and the outcome?
I thought the match was actually pretty good. It was great. In one corner, you have Kevin Owens, who I think by far is one of the best heels. He's one of the best old school style heels. I hope Michael agrees with me on that. And then in the other corner he has what he thinks is rightfully his.
Yeah. So I thought it was a good match too. Little disappointing. I thought my expectations were too high going in, considering what these two guys can do. I mean, it's not like they had an awful match. I expect a little bit more. What I was thrown off by were all the suckets in this match.
I agree. I was thrown off a little bit, too, because of the fact that they didn't really need to do that. You know, I think the crowd popped about that, too. The crowd really popped when Kevin Owens and Seth Rollins did it. I think they were just trying to one-up each other, in my opinion. When it came to what they were going to do next after the suck it.
Yeah, and it seemed kind of... I mean, I looked at Michael when it happened. I was like, really? Is it going to be a DX with Kevin Owens? That makes no sense. So to kind of do it kind of seemed uninspired. Considering the fucking Young Bucks make a living off of ripping off DX.
That's true. That's really true. This match was not bad. I like when my favorite part was when Kevin Owens went to get pop up Seth Rollins for the pop up powerbomb and he landed into the pedigree stance. I popped a little when I saw that. I was like, oh wow, you know. When I saw that, it was like when Seth Rollins went for the curb stomping, went into an RKO at WrestleMania.
Yeah. Well, same, Michael. Lots of suckers in this match. Felt out of place. Nasty gut buster from the top rope.
Nasty.
Rollins took that on his side. In my opinion, I haven't looked at the news, but I would say Rollins is either incredibly well at selling or he has broken rib or two, guys.
It's a possibility. You know, I'm a big Kevin Owens fan. I just didn't like the fact that Chris Jericho came out. You know, it also gives me another example of why I think the future of the Jericho and Kevin Owens feud is when KO hit Chris Jericho off the apron.
Yeah. It was. So, yeah, Michael, what did you think of the match?
I gave it an A minus. I thought the match throughout was a very, very good match.
Lots of frog splashes.
Well, there was... did you see very many botches?
No.
No. Which you came to expect from these two guys. This was one of those salivating matches where you were like, oh, sweet. I finally get to see these guys go at it. And you know it's going to be an awesome match. And that's what we got. As far as storytelling goes, I don't know if it ended the way that it should have. I definitely thought Triple H was going to be a part of this match at some point. We never saw that.
Your biggest gripe about the match was the ending.
Yeah, the ending was very lackluster for me. The ending that we got, I thought, was very, like, kind of, oh, this is the... It's Clash of Champions, so we'll give them that. You know, it didn't make sense story-wise. You hadn't seen Triple H since he helped Owens win the belt. Felt like it made more sense booking-wise. We have another pay-per-view here. It wasn't a pay-per-view when he came out. It was a Raw, but this was him defending his belt on his first pay-per-view. I felt like instead of Jericho coming out, it would have made more sense if that guy was Triple H.
Yep.
That's how I would have booked it, but I guess maybe they're saving that for the next pay-per-view because there's obviously going to be a rematch at Hell in a Cell, and in some way, Triple H is going to be involved in that match, whether you like it or not.
How I would have booked it, Kevin Owens talks a lot of trash in the ring.
Mm-hmm.
He had some classic
stuff. A
little
too much for my liking.
Oh, I love it.
I feel like it's way too hokey sometimes. Like, it's my time. It's kind of like it's gotten to the point with.
Does he make that face when he does it?
Well, it's how it's like. I was taking a shit, and I could hear him in the ring, just talking. Like it was to the point where it's kind of gotten almost Paige. This is my house.
No, it's
you know
no
what I mean?
Weird like that. Nowhere
it's
like that.
Like, can we stop that? All that talking in the ring, like we need to sell, like we need to sell ourselves even more. Like, can't you just wrestle? I don't feel like you need to yell at the guy. Like, this is I'm the face of the company. Can't just fucking wrestle, okay? It's gotten to the point with Kevin Owens a little bit where I'm getting a little pissed off at all the talking in the ring. And like, it's too hokey for me. It makes it feel more fake to me. I want it to feel more real. And all that shit does not make it feel more real to me. It definitely makes it feel
more
so.
Well, MMA guys and boxers talk trash.
Yeah, but you can't hear them. You know what I mean?
Right.
It's
due to all the mics WWE
has. It's to the point where it's a little too overdone for me. I would like to see a little less talking in the ring.
A little more class.
Well, no, it's not even about class. It's just a little less talking in the ring.
Right.
I don't feel like you need to talk in the ring to get your story over. I feel like that's what Owens is trying to do. He's trying to tell his story by talking while he's in the ring with the guy instead of just showing it with his wrestling.
Yeah. I tweeted this out tonight during the main event. I think you were taking a shit since you threw yourself under the bus. So Michael took a shit during this match.
I had to poop.
We're not PG.
Shit happens.
So shit does happen.
Literally.
Kevin Owens, while he was talking that he loved so much, he said to Rollins, "Architect, I'm the foundation."
Yeah.
And when he said this, I thought the finish was going to be the Hart Foundation, Jim the Anvil Neidhart, and Bret Hart come out, and that whole online stuff with Bret Hart and Seth Rollins being a big work. And it's going to be a stable with the Hart Foundation and Seth Rollins.
You guys are so stupid.
That's what I thought. Guys? Me?
I'd say, like, this is why, like, wrestlers look at people like us, and they're like, you guys are fucking idiots.
Well, I was kidding. I didn't really think the Hart Foundation.
Yeah. It's just kind of like Smart Mark's making something out of nothing. Like, you said foundation, so that means Bret Hart's got to be involved.
Can Jim Neidhart fit into a singlet?
Jim Neidhart cannot fit into the fucking arena.
Christ.
That motherfucker is so heavy. That guy is so off-key, it's not even funny.
He's weird.
That's what I'm saying. Yeah. Like, he is such a weird dude from all the drugs and stuff. I don't think he could fit in a fucking Backstreet Boys concert.
Yeah. Well, guys, the Hart Foundation did not come out to save Rollins. It was a stupid distraction finish, like we said. You didn't like it. I'm sure, Logan, did you like the finish in this?
I honestly did not. I didn't like the...
Did you tell your pet parakeet
like
was that high?
Because of the Jericho thing.
Yeah. Well, since we're all in agreement, that was Clash of Champions 2016, guys. Overall, we'll go around each of us. What would you grade this show on a scale of A, B, C, D, or F? Maybe not E. Don't use E.
Yeah, A, B, C, F. That's how the score goes.
Or you can use a D.
There's no D's anymore.
Put the D in.
No, there's no
D. Put that D in it.
Okay. That's going too far. But there,
oh, I go too far.
As far as school goes, there aren't any D's anymore.
Well, guys, Michael, what did you think of this show?
No, Logan, what did you think?
Oh, Logan, what did you think of Clash of Champions?
I think Backlash was better.
So what grade, Logan? We're asking for a grade. A, B, C, F.
Gave it Michael. C.
A C.
Solid C from Logan Mears. Michael, what you got?
I gave this pay-per-view a B, to be honest. I didn't think it was that terrible.
Okay.
What the fuck was that?
It's late, man.
Yeah. I gave it a B. I thought there was a lot of solid matches on this. I thought it matched up pretty well with the SmackDown pay-per-view, to be honest with you. I thought the SmackDown pay-per-view wasn't all... I mean, I thought it was a little better than this.
Wrong.
But I'm talking about the SmackDown pay-per-view. I thought it was a little better than this.
No, I know. I'm saying you're wrong. I'm saying they're even close.
Oh, well, I'm sorry that you feel that way. But I thought that Raw matched up pretty well. I didn't think it matched up totally to the SmackDown. I gave SmackDown the better grade with a B+. But I definitely didn't think it was bad. The Cesaro Sheamus. You had the women's match. You had the U.S. title match. Even though we didn't agree with the outcome, I thought it was a pretty damn good match. The main event, I thought, was a really good match. I felt like you had just as many quality matches on this pay-per-view as you had on the SmackDown pay-per-view.
Well, I'm going to make some history on the show tonight. I am going to score a show, I think, the lowest we've done. I'm giving this show a solid D, gentlemen.
We said there was no D.
I can bring back the D. I put the D in. Because it's not so bad, I want to call it enough. Fuck the school systems today.
They didn't like it.
Kids should still get a D, okay? I did not like this show. You know, the main reason I didn't like this show, nobody got what they wanted, it seemed like. You didn't get a big title change. The club, the women's title match, Roman Reigns won a belt. The main event was lackluster. Jericho and Sami Zayn was okay, but what did it mean? It didn't mean anything. Did anybody want to see Cesaro and Sheamus to begin with, and let alone with that finish after 7 goddamn matches? This show was full of frustration from the CWC match, which had so much potential, to cutting it in half with 10 minutes. Pissed me off across the board. One of the worst pay-per-views in the year, in my opinion. I did not like the show. I think you guys were way too generous to the main event. I thought it was really lackluster. Disappointed in the main event. Did not like it, guys. But we made it. Episode 28's in the books.
It's not in the books. We have to let Logan go.
We gotta let Logan go. His phone's about to die. So, Logan, one more time, where can everybody check out? Thank you so much for joining us again, man.
First things first, we didn't have no end zone cast, so that was another good reason why I didn't like it.
There you have it. Relegated to the pre-show. Well, Logan, where can everyone check you out at Future Pro Wrestling?
Future Pro Wrestling on Facebook, YouTube, just search it. Of course, keep an eye on what we're going to do, and of course, you're going to see us back at the pro show pay-per-view for No Mercy in 2 weeks.
Maybe.
No Mercy.
Depends on what the fans say, Logan. Depends on what the fans say, Logan.
Logan, thanks a lot, man. Let's get out of here. Get some rest.
But Logan, first of all, you guys, Future Pro Wrestling, you got any shows coming up?
Right now, I'm not exactly sure. We'll be back in your town or your neck of the woods.
Well, I'm just saying, any neck of the woods. Do you have any bigger names lined up for your main event?
What was that, Michael?
Do you have any bigger names lined up for your main event in the future that you're...
Any interviews or anything everyone should check out?
Not at this time. But I am, definitely trying to help out Slam Pigs podcast with a couple interviews, so you never know.
Oh, look at that. Appreciate that, Logan. Michael, you want to say your good nights and farewells to our friend Logan for staying up? You're in 2 takes. This was a bitch of a show to get done. But we made it.
We still got more.
We got a little bit more, but Logan's got to get out of here, Michael.
See you. Bye, Logan.
Thanks, Michael.
Hey, man, thank you so much. We'll catch you after No Moisey.
No Moisey.
Later, man. Have a good night. All right, Michael.
That was Logan.
That was Logan.
He made it. His phone, unfortunately, couldn't make it to the end of the show, but
I'm
we can.
I'm surprised he made it this far with his low percentage.
I'm surprised he did, too, with the way he does things.
I'll be serious.
I'm being serious.
But we're back to
that
the...
guy doesn't belong on the show, Travis. He doesn't. I think let's be honest. I mean, the fans, once again, we're going to have a poll this week. Who should be our post-show guest? Should it be Logan Mears? And we're going to have some other choices, whether it be maybe Corey the Bagel Guy, maybe Eric Amard, or one of the choices I'm going to put on there is anyone else. Anyone else.
Jesus Christ.
Could be Jocelyn from the Hokey Pokey.
It will never be Jocelyn, for one.
She might. She could make an appearance.
Do you want to talk about Pokemon for 2 hours?
No,
I don't. So.
But, I mean, it could be anyone. Those are all your choices, guys. So, please, do us proud. Vote honestly. He's not going to have his feelings hurt.
I don't even know if I want to put this poll up. It's going to be up to you because I don't want to
hurt feelings. We could do a poll. It could be a poll. Let's do this poll instead.
Okay.
Instead of the Logan thing, let's do who would you rather have on the show? Me or Logan?
As the co-host?
Yeah. I mean, you have him on for all your post shows. You can have him on for all your shows.
Oh, we'll do fine. What if Logan wins?
Then I guess I won't be making any more appearances.
Nobody wants that. Let's not.
There might be a lot of people.
Let's not get silly.
I'm just saying. Let's do that.
It's time for this week's News and Rumors.
News and Rumors.
Paige is back, Michael. She's cleared to go. That leads me to believe that tomorrow night on Raw, Paige could be coming out, interrupting the Charlotte promo. Can you see that? As a face. Rejuvenation.
Possibly.
For a career.
Hopefully, I think. I think it's time for a little bit of a change in the women's division. I think we need a new contender. Maybe if it's not Paige being the number one contender, maybe it's her in the mix with Bayley and Sasha Banks. Triple threat maybe for the number one contender down the line. I definitely think this could be an opportunity for rejuvenation. It depends on her attitude when she comes back, to be honest with you. I think that's where the WWE is looking at it. With her boyfriend being gone and all that, it definitely comes to say, where are you at in your career as far as mentally? Do you want to help this company? Do you not want to help this company? I think that's where we are.
Well, we'll see. I'm excited to see her back.
Hopefully. What do you think?
What do I think? About what?
About Paige. Where do you think she should be booked if she comes back tomorrow?
I think she's definitely way overdue for rejuvenation. I think maybe they play a little Jeff Hardy game with her. Okay, we're trusting you. Don't let us down. If she lets them down, back to the Jeff Hardy route she goes. It's all about trust. So we'll see. It's for one, it's good to have her back. Love me some Paige. Another former diva in the news this week. Again, Sonny was arrested, Michael.
Sonny.
Jesus.
Tammy Lynn.
What a woman. The streak of destruction this woman has trailblazed is Hall of Fame worthy in itself for another Hall of Fame.
And it's sad.
She had the really world
she
in
was
her
the
hands.
She was the original diva, as far as I'm concerned.
Inducted 5 years ago in the Hall of Fame. Everyone thought she got her shit together. She looked great.
Yep.
Made the rounds in porn.
Yeah, that's when
some of the worst porn ever made.
I mean, I hate to compare it to this, but you compare it to, like, China. China, and unfortunately, China is no longer with us. I hope that's not the road that Sonny's going down. We all know that she had troubles with the law. She was arrested again this week for a probation violation. We don't know the details on the probation violation. Why was she on probation to begin with?
Maybe a DUI. I know she had a restraining order from a guy for a couple years, and she kept violating that. I cannot keep up with the woman, so who knows? I'm sure it'll come out in the wash.
Well, Sonny, if you're listening to us, hopefully you're...
Get some help, because we loved you when we were kids.
You were definitely an inspiration for us in a certain way when we were kids.
There you go.
but we definitely, in all honesty, we hope the best for you. Hopefully you can get your shit together. Get where you need to get. I know that we've both been in a certain situation where, kind of like you, where we need to get our shit together. So it's possible for you. We wish the best for you in all your future endeavors.
First of all, 15, 20 years ago, if you came to us and said, okay, one day China and Sonny are going to be in porn. But China's going to have the better porn. I would have called you a liar, Mean Gene. I would have looked you right in the eye and said, you're an ugly liar. That's not what happened.
No.
Yeah, so...
thanks for insinuating that we both watched both those porns.
You know, everyone knows we did. First of all, we're the Slam Pigs podcast. We're not scholarly gentlemen sitting up late sipping on tea. No. Slam Pigs podcast.
Who haven't checked out those porns, make sure to go check them out.
Actually, don't, because they're... It's going to traumatize you, one or the other. Yeah. An oversized, or a so.
You have an oversized, certain stuff.
Shout out to Joe Quiotes. He was always a big fan.
Joe Quiotes.
When I met him at that MMA thing, he had like three or four, like, I want to say BBW type women with him. So he,
big, beautiful women.
They were beautiful women. He likes to dive right big. In. Roll sleeves up, dive into the bakery.
Well, Quiotes, whatever you're into, buddy.
It's been a long show.
Anything else in the news this week?
No, it's been a slow news week. Luckily, when you took your hiatus, not much happened. So
yeah, I mean, when I took my hiatus, so did everybody else.
Talks to Matt Hardy possibly having.
Yes, there's rumors that WWE and Matt Hardy are in talks of a possible return.
And also, Lince Dorado from the CWC.
Yeah,
possible contract signs. So.
What are your thoughts on Matt Hardy? What do you think?
I know
you've promoted TNA here lately. With the Matt Hardy character, you like it.
I did not talk about this with you. I talked about it on the show that it will never see the light of day because it's gone. Lost it with Logan. Have you heard the talks with WWE and TNA? Mm-hmm. WWE being one of the guys that are interested in buying TNA Wrestling, which could lead to TNA being on the network.
For what, $5?
Here's the funny part. Do you know what, back in the day when WCW was sold to WWE, WCW...
It wasn't sold for much.
$2 million.
Yeah.
WCW was the biggest wrestling company in the world. TNA has never been the biggest wrestling company in the world. TNA is trying to sell their company for how much you think? Take a shot in the dark.
$5 million?
$40 million, Michael. They're asking $40 million. Now, that's their out-of-the-gate price. Obviously, that always they always lower. Dixie Carter. Yeah. I'm going to let this laugh right out like a Hulk Hogan ovation.
Sorry.
$40 million. All right,
I'm done. Sorry.
Unbelievable. First of all, TNA. Well, that's the segment on that. That's pretty much all we got. We'll see who bought. Ring of Honor is also interested. There's a couple. The Fight Network, I believe, owns part of TNA.
What was I laughing at earlier that was really funny? We were both laughing at it. Oh, it was probably Logan. Could have been.
Anything else you want to add this week?
As most of our listeners probably do.
Hey, it was good to have you back.
Yeah. It was good to have you back.
I'm stumbling everywhere. What? You face the right little place.
Yeah. I was happy to be back. I'm glad we did this. I needed this.
It's therapeutic.
Yes, it definitely is for me. Definitely, especially when you have a guest like Logan Mirrors on here.
Will you get off the Logan Mirrors?
What?
Just stop running them into the ground.
You called him that.
No, not the name. I'm just saying how he did on the show. First of all, we're up to almost 30 shows. We got a little bit of experience doing this. Were we great in the beginning? I know you think yourself's great before you even started the podcast, but...
I mean, this wasn't his first time on the show, and I definitely don't feel like it was much better than before.
Next week on Slam Pigs.
Just throwing that out there. Your thoughts, Travis, on Logan on the show this week.
I think you need to stay fired up more, but I think he can hang when he wants to.
That's Travis being publicly correct.
No, I wasn't. I was telling the truth. That's exactly how I feel about it. I think when he gets fired up, it's good. Why you gotta put your chin all high? You're thinking about something?
Did you ever think that he was fired up for this show?
I thought he was, about Roman.
Definitely sounded like he was more into that Madden.
Well, it's also 2 in the morning, and this is our second take, so...
Okay.
Yeah.
I mean, but when we started the show, was it any better?
Michael, next week...
No, we're not getting off this.
Another thing
I want to talk about is your little fucking snap you had.
Oh, saving it till the end. Here we go.
Your little Bob Backlund snap you had last week on me.
Let me pack one up.
Yeah.
Let me hear it.
Whoopsie. Like, I just want to know what the fuck was that all about, brother.
Go back and listen, brother.
Brother.
Go back. go back to that episode and listen to it.
Have I ever been really disrespectful to you on the show?
Really?
Yeah. I feel like I've been a complete gentleman.
To me?
To you. Yeah, to you.
Guys, go back.
Now, everyone else, they're fair game. But I try to be considerate to you on the show. I let you cut me off numerous times every week on this show, and I don't say a word about it.
I think I've gotten better at it.
And, you know, I try to respect your opinions. You know, I try to give you the reins, no pun intended.
Don't stop saying that. You already used that.
Well, I'm just saying. That's how I roll.
Why is everything a Roman Reigns joke?
Well, anytime you say the word reigns, it's got to be.
Look.
Yeah, let's hear your explanation.
I had enough last week.
They're pothead Pat.
Who's Pat?
I don't know.
Bottom line is this. I've had a couple friends on here. Hey, I haven't been very nice to him, have you?
Couple friends?
Lee's my friend.
He's your friend.
Lee is my friend.
Why?
Adam loved him when he was on the Hard and Ace one. I think he may be Adam's all-time favorite guest.
Why?
Now, this week...
Why? Why does Adam like him?
He just does. Lee's a good guy. Lee is a good guy.
Hello, my name's Lee.
Oh, I didn't know you hated the country, so you want to talk about someone being prejudiced.
It's just, hello, my name is Lee.
Yeah, that's how he talks.
I am on the hard-to-name podcast.
No, go back and listen. See, you wouldn't know because you're too good to listen to
my question for Michael.
Hey, if you had another show, I'd listen to it. Fucking asshole. Won't even give it a shot. You're going to be on it next week. You don't know what the fucking format is.
I don't need to.
You want
to
do 2 weeks going off the air with me pissed. Pissed off. No, shut up.
I can't even be serious.
No, I was taking it home and you had to bring up past wounds.
I am the format.
You think I'm proud?
That's my new nickname. I am the format.
You are the format.
So, your format.
Oh, what if TNA has a copyright to this delete Matt
Could
Hardy?
Could be.
And he comes in as format.
Could be.
And he can use it like everything's format. This is the format. He can use it different ways.
He could.
See,
and guess what? I'd sue the fuck out of him.
47 writers.
I'm the format.
47 writers in that fucking company. We just couldn't book a whole show.
Yeah, we could have. But to be honest, I don't like your attitude.
I don't really give a horse's ass.
Well, that's good.
I'm losing my voice.
Are you? You're getting all hoarse.
I hate that.
Are you all right?
I hate that.
One time, your voice is going to change for good.
Usually when I wake up in the morning, my voice does that. Like, say good morning to whoever. And it's
good morning.
Hello. I hate it. Don't fuck with me.
Sound like Mr. Bean.
Hey.
Hey.
Can we end the show on a good note this week?
I want to go over this. Needs to be talked about. The fans want
to
know.
You're just jacking off around the bushes, not getting to the point.
Why am I jacking off around the
bushes?
Because
that's what you do.
That's just a little much.
Ugh.
Yeah, you ought to be ashamed you said
really?
That.
Really? All the shit you've said on the show.
I'm just saying that's...
The greatest hits episode will come one day. And it's going to be just Michael being lewd. And lewd and rude. Michael's compilation. The best of Michael.
Ricky Rude?
Bobby.
Lex Luger? Gotcha.
So what's your beef?
So, who's the better Beverly?
Who's the better Beverly?
Bo or Blake?
I guess now it would be Bo, who I thought was Blake. I'm still waiting on your thing, your issue you wanted to address. You're still beating around the bush. Is that a better way to describe it?
Do you have like a hidden agenda? Is there something that you need to say to me that where it just came out and snapped out at the end of a show last week? Is there anything you need to address?
I think if you could spend 2 seconds putting yourself in somebody else's shoes. You put me in a spot certain weeks.
Okay.
When you're rude to Logan, rude to Lee. Nice to love the bagel guy. Can't be bothered with the bagel guy.
He doesn't do anything that pisses me off.
Eric Amard. Couldn't be bothered. Couldn't be fucked with.
No. See, go back and listen to that show.
But you treated him with a lot more class and respect than a Logan Mirrors, Professor Lee.
What's his name?
Logan Mirrors.
What's his real name?
Logan Myers.
Yeah. See, so don't give me shit when you pick on him too.
How's that? That's his ring name. Logan Mirrors. How's that picking on him?
That's his ring name.
Okay. Really? Is it disrespectful to say Joe Chioti or Chioda? Chioti kind of sounds like shit.
Well, you're the one that came up with it.
And guys, by the way, Joe Chioti's isn't real.
Yeah, he
doesn't exist.
You're welcome for that.
Wait till the April Fool's episode, guys.
That's definitely on there.
That's going to be classic.
But I don't want to hear about me being disrespectful to guests, okay? I'm respectful to guests until they voice opinions that are fucking stupid.
this week, and you can go back and listen because this episode is going to drop in the morning. From the get, you were jumping down. I almost said Lee. Logan's shit.
Well, he deserved it.
He didn't do anything.
He talked shit.
He said, hello, thanks for having me on the show. Yeah. Well, let's just fuck him up. Verbally.
Like I said before, I say what other people
and you
are
know,
thinking.
And, no. And you know, it's frustrating.
I say what other people are thinking.
No, I agree with that. Because I get feedback, good and bad, about guests. But I will say this. You put me in a spot. And I can only take so much.
Oh.
See?
Well, that's fine.
I'm only human.
I don't need to come back on the show if that's how you feel.
I'm only human.
Just saying.
Well, you can get the fuck out of here.
All right, I will.
Show's over.
I'm done with this show.
Slam pig pup.
It's the last appearance of me on the show.
Get the fuck out.
Yep, I'm out of here.
Get out. Security.
I'm done.
Get him out.
Fuck this show.
We'll see you guys
Logan
next
Mayer
week.
Logan Mayer sucks!
You suck. Get out of my studio.
Suck it.
Next week,
story
going solo.
Story of the show tonight. It's a new... bunch of suck-its.
He still cuts me off even when he quits the show. Look at that shit. We'll see if we can get this shit resolved by next week. Until then, it looks like I'm flying solo. A lot of people are going to be fucking happy. God damn it. Slam Pigs Podcast.